Good, so now let's have a look at histograms and resource labeling. Now remember I said you have to know about a Gantt chart before we know about histograms or resource labeling. So let's just talk about resource labeling for now. Now look at this over here. You can see this is a Gantt chart we just spoke about. So we said there's activities, there's durations, there's precedence, and then there's a flow throughout these. The first thing we need to realize, and I'm going to come back to that in a moment, the first thing we need to realize is that these blocks or the activities are activities which are going to be executed by, let's say, people resource at this moment. So I want you to see, when I talk about A, B, C's and D's over here, I want you to see real activities. These are stuff like digging a hole, mixing concrete, building a wall, putting on a roof. These are real activities in our project. Okay, and then we've got the durations, we've got the flow or the precedence, and then we've got the flow throughout the project. Good, so this is what we did earlier. Now let's have a look at this project over here. We just said now that there's a flow over there, and we said in the previous example that you can either do activity B, you can either start on 2 or you can start on 4 on this example, because you've got a float of 2 and you're not going to influence the total duration of the project. Okay, so we use the float to our advantage, but we don't influence the end of the project or the final duration of the project. So whether we start over there or whether we start over there, it's not going to have an influence. But look at the third iteration, and what we are actually doing over here, we are breaking the rules a bit. We are breaking the rules a bit, because what we do now, we are saying, but let's not start it over there or over there. Let's start it over there, yeah, on 2. I'm talking about activity B. And then we pack the rest of the project behind that in. So you can say, I'm not going to do these in parallel, although I can. I'm going to do that afterwards, and then I'm going to do activity D after that. So what I'm doing is I'm squashing activity B in between activity A and C. And I'm, by doing that, I am exiting, or I'm increasing the full duration or the total duration of my project at the end of the day. And why would I want to do that? Why would I want to do that? And I'm just giving you a glimpse on the next video. But let's say this over here takes the same resource. Let's say this is the these guys are building a wall on the southern side and these guys are building a wall on the eastern side. It means that I'm going to have to, and let's just pretend you need one guy to build one piece of wall up a day. No? Then you're going to have one person building a wall, that same person building another wall. Then I'm going to get two people in to build the two parts of wall, and I'm going to get another person in to build the two parts of the wall, two people. So it means for this over here, I'm going to need two people per day. But what if I can move it out and my client is fine, the fact that we say we're going to actually complete this project 2 days later, but I'm going to save you two people who's going to work at once, to an extra person at once in terms of the project. And that's where we're going to head with all of this when we talk about histograms.